Over the last 2 years, our hidden assets recovery division has seen an explosion in the growth of inquiries for asset recovery for family law and divorce cases. It used to be that asset recovery was for judgments or maybe embezzlement, sometimes Ponzi schemes, but the divorce case percentage was maybe 10, sometimes 15% of the overall inquiries. In the last 24 months, the inquiries have grown to more than 50%. More than half the inquiries are divorces. And the reason why is because family estates, family asset classes have grown quite a bit. It used to be that typical divorce was looking to split up $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, $80,000, maybe $100,000. Now, family asset classes can be hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars for a typical average middle-class family even. You may have 401k funds, there may be retirement funds, there may be business interest, there may be other assets in the estate which maybe aren't as liquid. So the parties sometimes have an incentive to try to hide some of these assets. They may try to take a couple hundred thousand dollars and stash it, figuring that instead of giving half of $200,000, they're ahead 100 grand, right? So the one thing we have found is of all the different types of people who conceal and hide assets, divorce parties are the worst at hiding them. It can almost always be found even in other cases, but people who are trying to hide assets in divorce have no idea what they're doing. Sometimes they'll do something as simple as trying to quit claim a property to their cousin. The quit claim creates a record. Sometimes they'll do something with Bitcoin or cryptocurrency and it leaves a record. We've seen cases where somebody has purchased a vehicle, put it in somebody else's name, but they continue to pay the insurance. The methods that amateur asset concealers use in most divorce cases are very, very easily discovered. And sometimes the amounts are substantial, several hundred thousand dollars in many cases. So this is a really good article in Forbes that came out a couple years ago about hiding assets in divorce, where they even recognize it. Finding hidden assets increase the likelihood that you're treated equitably in divorce. Not only will you get the money, but judges and courts don't like when they find somebody trying to be sketchy in hiding assets. The only problem I have with this article is it says typical hiding spots is denying assets exist, transferring to third party, claiming it was lost, creating false debt. The only one on here that's actually we see is transferring to a third party. The other ones we hardly ever see. One more recent method of hiding assets is prepaying taxes. You'll have a party that will take money, pay it to the IRS. It'll show as a tax payment, but in many cases, they're just prepaying future years, so that money doesn't show as an asset and they can use it as a value later. And then it talks about red flags. Here's a perfect one on tax returns. But if you are in the case where there's a family law activity, a divorce, death in the family, maybe even a child support case or spousal maintenance, you want to make sure that you're getting a good picture of the assets. Don't go by the financial disclosure that's provided to you by the other side. You want to make sure you verify everything, verify all the accounts, make sure there's nothing missing, make sure there's no real estate that's in another county that's in somebody else's name. There's many, many ways that somebody could try to hide assets and keep you from getting your fair share of that settlement, whether it's a divorce or even a probate, death in the family.